Hello and welcome to Tech.Decoded. I'm Henry Gabb, editor of the Parallel Universe. Today I'm here with Bill Savage, Vice President and General Manager of Compute Performance and Developer Products. Welcome, Bill.
Hello, Henry.
So, Bill, Intel recently announced the oneAPI initiative. Can you tell us what oneAPI is and the vision behind it?
It's about architecture, Henry, both hardware and software. As Intel expands the architectures we're supporting to address the emerging data-centric workloads for customers, we needed to architect a software solution that would simplify the programming of those diverse architectures. So the main vision of oneAPI was to give a programming abstraction that would unify and simplify the diverse architectures that meet customer workload needs.
And so in your view, what are the major aspects of oneAPI?
There's two major aspects. And industry specification, where we're specifying a language and a set of APIs for the industry, as well as a low-level interface to hardware. And the second part is an Intel product, the oneAPI product, that implements the compilers for that language, the libraries for those APIs, but also includes debuggers, analysis tools, and other related products and tools that support the oneAPI standard.
Now, you've experienced and even driven some of the major inflection points in software. As an example, the move from serial performance to parallel performance. Can you reflect on those inflection points?
Yeah. Each of those inflection points that I've been involved in and observed in the industry were motivated by a change in hardware architecture. For example, the push for parallel software was motivated by the need for multi-core architectures. Multi-core architectures were needed because we couldn't continue to scale at frequency. So the reality of multi-core architectures required a software solution. And then another inflection point in the industry was when GPUs started to provide compute capabilities in the data center, a software solution was needed to give access to the GPU architecture. And a final one that we've observed was the emergence of deep learning and artificial intelligence. And as that came to the industry, there needed to be a set of software that enabled that change in the industry. And oneAPI is along those journeys, the experience that we've had internally to Intel, as well as our observations of our competitors in the industry, all formed together for us to architect the exact needed solution for the oneAPI diverse architecture.
And so how does cross-architecture and cross-vendor development help the developers in the developer community?
In two ways. The language that we've selected, Data Parallel C++, lets them program in a common programming language that can cross these architectures as well as crossing vendors. Oftentimes, solutions in languages in particular, in the case of CUDA, is vendor-specific, and oneAPI is open, standard, available for multiple architectures and vendors. And then the libraries as well helps the developer cross architectures and vendors with a common software investment. So the benefit to developers are lowering their cost in addressing a much broader market of diverse architectures.
And so what differentiates oneAPI from other approaches?
The language is different than previous language. Our Data Parallel C++ delivers uncompromised performance by sharing a common source language that can cross not only architectures but vendors. So we were very diligent to find a language that can do that. Java delivered cross architecture but not performance. OpenCL attempted to deliver on this promise. We think we found a language that does. Through explicit expression of parallel kernels, the compiler can create the threading, the vectorization, and the other operations needed to fully exploit the parallelism of multiple architectures. And then the libraries as well, we're motivated as Intel to give libraries that actually cross architecture boundaries. Up till this point, most vendors have been motivated only to enable a single architecture.
And so we'll have a full suite of tools, presumably, that will give complete visibility into the hardware. Is that correct?
Largely, yes. That the full suite of tools, analysis, as well as compilers and libraries, will give full insight into the hardware and allow developers to fully exploit that hardware and its performance with a shared source code investment.
Well, my favorite part of the interview is to ask, do you care to make any bold predictions for the next 5 to 10 years?
Bold predictions. Well, I do want to be clear. oneAPI is a phased approach. It's going to be a multi-year effort. We'll introduce our first beta this year, a product later. We need to work with partners in the industry. So this is a multi-year effort with many phases. So if I'm looking in the future, we have multiple vendors across the industry, including some of our competitors, have adopted oneAPI as the standard for programming in the data center, and that Intel has its broad reach of architectures deployed in the industry, fully enabled by that software.
Thanks, Bill, for sharing your insights today. We're all excited about oneAPI.
Thank you, Henry.
I'm Henry Gabb with Tech Decoded. Please visit our website for more information about oneAPI.
Thanks for watching this video. If you liked it and haven't seen any of our other videos, subscribe to the Intel Software YouTube channel. You can also connect with other developers and enthusiasts in the comments. See you all next time.